process, a very typical of Kent kind of architecture. It's a house with a conical part at the end, and this conical part had a kiln inside, and the hops would be laid on the kiln, and the kiln would warm them up and dry them out. And then at the top there's a white weather vane kind of thing, which swivels then in the direction of the wind and enables the hops and the smoke to then to escape the moisture from the hops, rather, and that escapes then from these buildings. And we'll, I believe we'll see some of those on the way back. We're going to take the scenic route back now, which is a little bit more pleasant in fact than the original route that we came out on. This is a route where we've got a little bit more time to play with, so we can go through and see the Garden of England, we'll see some host houses, we'll see some other hops and other crops being grown. A very common and notable crop is the yellow crop of rapeseed oil. Rapeseed oil used to make vegetable oil, as we call it, or canola, as it's known in the States, and that's a very striking yellow colour when those hops can be seen. And we'll see some of those, and also some vineyards, because it's a growing tradition, in fact, that as the weather is getting a bit warmer and technology is improving, and certain grape varieties have been found which can be cultivated in this climate, still a relatively cold climate, but they can be cultivated. So there are some vineyards on the left there. That's an host house there, looks in fact like it's been converted into a house, but that is the traditional design of the host house there, with the conical part at the end. So it was originally kind of a barn, really, and they'd be stored there, and then at the one end there, the drying process would take place. But yeah, days like today, it's quite easy to imagine that vineyards are here, grown on the south-facing crops, most of all, and that's very much a new and recent tradition. And also the sparkling wine has been brewed up here in Kent, and all the way up to the borders of London. In fact, in Dorking, just south of London, there's quite a large vineyard there which brews sparkling wine, and the quality is very highly rated by experts, and much to the chagrin of the French in the Champagne region. The wine here, the sparkling wine, which can't legally be called champagne unless it actually comes from that region, but it is actually proving to be very popular and very high quality and very highly rated by the experts. Here then, just passing under the railway, which is the high speed railway in Canada, under the motorway in fact, which we drove across on the way here, the motorway becomes our outlook for the interstate highways. And so, as I say, this is a country road taking us back then, the A20, through the more rural Kent. And Kent, it's a name actually which is derived from the Celtic tribe Cantiaci, who originally lived here. But they were later conquered by the Romans. The Cantiaci were then no longer the indigenous, you could say. The Romans came along, built a number of different forts and strongholds here. Canterbury was one of those, and they built the roads in and around Canterbury, the region. And then later, after the Romans left, then there was the Anglo-Saxons and the Dukes, who sort of populated the area, then often living in the field, invaded on quite a regular basis. In fact, they invaded Canterbury and raided Canterbury, and even murdered a religious man called St. Alphage, who offered his life then essentially in order to save the lives of children. And then it was that was the population then for quite a long time. Nowadays, in fact, there is a tradition that people in the east of Kent, east of the River Medway, they're known as Men of Kent or Maids of Kent, and then west of the Medway, they're called Kentish Men or Kentish Maids. So they have this distinction between the two natives of the region. But it's Castle region.
Man of Kent.
So Dave here, our driver, is a man of Kent, according to that description. Don't ever call him a Kentish man, he'll get very upset with you. Here on the right, then, we've got these are actually modern buildings, but they've got the roof done in the style of the Oyster houses. I'm not a fan of these, personally. They are made to look, they're not even conical, they're really kind of a pyramid shape there. And they're made to look a pastiche style, made to look like the old style. And people in their old classic cars taking a spin. In front of us we have some kind of a curious three-wheel device which doesn't look particularly nice, so hopefully that won't lead our journey back to Kent, which will be, as I say, through the more scenic route then through the landscape of Kent, the garden of England. I will sit back and let you relax and enjoy the ride.
My car looks like it tips back and forth.
It's a three-wheeler.
the black tunnel's got the things in it.
Oh, yeah, it's got the things as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
coach driving, I used to do the whole weekends. Just evenings and weekends. But then I got made redundant in 2008. Turned the hobby into a career. And at the time, it's like, didn't know how much work I was going to get, so I did my lorry licence as well. So, I've got options. Because I work in the office normally, the assistant office manager, so I'm qualified traffic manager as well, which you have to do a qualification for.
Yeah, think that's how it is.